Colt 4 has the unique courtroom experience, respect of his peers, and the conservative values we need to be a judge for the people of Livingston, St. Helena, and Tangipahoa parishes. Vote for what matters. Elect Colt 4, District Court Judge.
Well, Barry Bradford came to Kentwood to have good news at the Rotary Club here. We're at the cafe where he said that in just a matter of days, the contract will be awarded to build the long-sought Kentwood Library. And boy, therein hangs a tale. You've been at this for years trying to assemble the money.
We have indeed. We started working on this in 2013, and we finally have all our ducks in a row now. We have some help from the state, the capital outlay, and we hope we'll be able to break ground here in the next month or so. As you said, we will have the contractor approved by the board and the parish council within the next few days.
So you say it will cost $2.8 million. That's a lot of money.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Actually, it's a little closer to $2.9 million with everything that we're doing. We have $1.6 million set aside in our budget, and then we'll have $1.16 million that the state is going to provide us through this grant, and we have some extra funds we'll be able to use to get us over the top. So, right.
Why so expensive?
Well, I think one of the reasons is because materials are expensive right now. Of course, the hurricanes have come through. I think that's caused material prices to go up. Steel prices are up. So I think the pandemic has created some increase in materials costs. So I think those are the reasons.
Plus, there will be a lot of things at this library.
Oh, very much so. We'll have a computer lab. We'll have a nice meeting room space. We'll have a nice children's area. We're going to have an Omniglobe, which is a sort of an astronomical educational tool, and plenty of space. It'll be 8,100 square feet, which is much larger than the current library.
Well, you know, at this time that we're all rediscovering drive-ins, you were ahead of the curve because your plans are to have an outdoor amphitheater movie theater.
That's right. We thought several years ago, we thought, well, you know, Kentwood doesn't have a theater any longer. They used to. Macomb doesn't have a theater. The closest theater is in Hammond. So we thought, well, have an outdoor theater here. It'll be free. We pay a movie licensing already for that. And we can show movies, family-friendly movies. People can come, bring their kids, bring food and drinks, and it'll just be a great time.
Well, maybe it's because I'm an old-timer and remember fondly drive-ins, but I love the idea of an outdoor movie venue.
I do, too, and it's especially good now because, you know, you're talking about a situation being better if you're outside with the COVID and all. I love movie theaters. I grew up going to them, so, yeah, that's close to my heart, too.
Well, let's talk about the system as a whole now, and libraries are back open. Obviously, it's phase three, which is better than it was, but it's not normal.
No, it's not quite normal. We are allowing, of course, patrons into our branches. We're continuing curbside service. Patrons can now browse the stacks where we had closed off the stacks before, the shelves. So that's now open. We are still continuing our virtual programs. We have some more services available now than we did before, but we still have a few restrictions. We aren't allowing anyone to use our meeting rooms right now, and our restrooms are closed off. But there are more things available now than ever. You certainly can call us, use our online services. We have a ton of stuff you can access through our website, tangilibrary.com.
Can you also now just hang out in the library, maybe use the Wi-Fi?
You can. You can. Either inside or outside, you're welcome to use our Wi-Fi. Our computers are available for use. Our Wi-Fi goes out about 100 yards from our building, so as long as you're within 100 yards of our buildings, you can use that high-speed internet.
Barry, you know, you're a humble guy. I know if I asked you what else you wanted to share, you wouldn't bring up the big award you just got from a veterans group.
Well, yes, our local history and genealogy department has worked with our Vietnam veterans over the past few years and to help them get materials that they wanted for the public, to educate the public about that era. And they honored especially our local history and genealogy librarians, Bill Dorman and Mike Agnello, who work in the department. They got letters of commendation, and we also got a plaque that we hung up in our department. And we're very proud of that. That was a wonderful ceremony.
You know, you're a real leader. I mean, the library system, but you did it, adding this to the AME branch especially, to help with genealogy research.
I very much believe in local history. I believe in preserving history, preserving artifacts. We have an archive. Because as my father told me when I was a young boy, he said, if someone passes away and they haven't written down those stories or recorded them, they're lost. And that stuck with me. And I think there's a lot of wisdom, a lot of valuable insight that people have that needs to be preserved. And so I'm a big believer in history and preserving history.
Well, great segue into the fact that the library system is celebrating a big birthday.
Yes, indeed. We're at our 75th anniversary this year. We're very happy. Our library opened as a parish-funded library in July of 1945, right after D-Day. It's been thriving since, and we're very proud of the fact we've been able to serve the public for these 75 years.
Well, maybe after the pandemic, which hopefully will be over early next year with the arrival of great vaccines. Mm-hmm. Look, I'm an optimist.
Yeah,
but whenever it's over, maybe we can do the 75th thing all over again.
Yeah, that would be great. We'll have some programs. We were planning to bring in the Victory Bells this year, which I love the Victory Bells. I don't know if you're familiar with them. But
from the World War II Museum.
World War II Museum. And they're fantastic. They're kind of an Andrews Sisters singing group. But we will do this. We had a D-Day presentation ready to go this year. We'll do it. We'll just do it next year instead of this year.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, we got mobile hotspots coming. I wanted to tell everybody about that. We're planning to get in about 40 mobile hotspots, and we will catalog them, which means people can check them out, take them home for a certain length of time, and use them to access the internet wherever they are, even in La Ronger or Kentwood or any other location where Wi-Fi is or internet access is spotty. So we're planning to do that soon and hope it'll help the communities around us.
So you can check one out like a book.
Yes, indeed. Right. And you'll be able to use it on your computer or laptop or other device to get access through the cell towers.
If, for instance, you're in a rural area or even Kentwood here where there's not good internet available.
That's correct. Instead of depending on satellite internet, which can be iffy, or dial-up, which is slow, you'll be able to get high-speed internet through these mobile hotspots.
Hi, I'm Chase Sharkey with Sharkey Mechanical. Our team of experts handles some of the largest and most complex air conditioning systems in the state. Give us a call today and let us attack your air conditioning needs. 225-222-3332.